types of hosts. Types of hosts. Sir, here we have three types of hosts. One is definitive host. Definitive host or primary host. It is also known as primary host. Okay. Next, if you take intermediate host or secondary host. Or secondary host. Third one is reservoir host. Third one is a reservoir host. Okay. So here we have three types of hosts. Definitive host, intermediate host, reservoir host. Okay. See here, if you look at the definitive host, the host which harbors, which lodges adult stages or mature stages or sexual phases are known as definitive hosts. The host in which parasite completes its sexual life cycle is called as definitive host. Means the mature phases, mature stages, next sexual phases, adult stages are present. So in the definitive host, parasite mature stages are present, or sexual stages are present, or adult stages are present. This is one kind of definition. The host which harbors, which lodges mature stages or sexual stages or adult stages is called as definitive host. There is another definition. The host in which parasite completes its sexual life cycle. If parasite completes its sexual life cycle, then that host is called as definitive host. For example, see Anopheles mosquito, Anopheles for Plasmodium vivax. So this female Anopheles mosquito, what is this? Female Anopheles mosquito for Plasmodium vivax. Means Plasmodium vivax completes its sexual life cycle in the female Anopheles mosquito. Plasmodium vivax completes its sexual life cycle in the female Anopheles mosquito. Okay, that is. Next, human being or man for Eukarya. Man for Eukarya. Means Eukarya bancrofti parasite completes its sexual life cycle in the man. So, the parasite completes its sexual life cycle in the primary host or definitive host. That is the thing about the definitive host. So what is the second type of host? Intermediate host. What is the second one? Intermediate host. That is also called as what, sir? Secondary host. That is also called as what? Secondary host. Sir, intermediate host or secondary host, it lodges, harbors asexual phases, larval phases, immature phases. So they have intermediate host gives states look site for the shelter for the immature stages or immature forms or larval forms or asexual forms. So intermediate hosts are the host in which parasites completes their asexual life cycle. Parasites complete which life cycle? Asexual life cycle. So intermediate hosts or secondary hosts, they gives space, they lodges, they harbors immature forms, larval forms, asexual forms. Otherwise, the secondary host is the host in which parasite completes its asexual life cycle. Asexual life cycle are known as intermediate hosts or secondary hosts. Okay, next example. So if you take the example, man for Plasmodium vivax. So man for Plasmodium vivax. means Plasmodium vivax completes its asexual life cycle in man. Then man is secondary host for which parasite? Plasmodium vivax parasite. Okay, next. So if you take Culex mosquito, which one? Female Culex mosquito. So female Culex mosquito for Ucararia. For what? Ucararia. So here in the life cycle, if you take female Culex mosquito has means asexual life cycle of Ucararia. So Ucararia completes asexual life cycle in the Culex mosquito. Next, Plasmodium vivax completes its asexual life cycle in the man. So man and female Culex are nothing but they are intermediate hosts or secondary hosts. Okay, next. Reservoir hosts. Reservoir host. So reservoir host means it is a host in which parasite lives temporarily for the maintenance of its infective stage when the main host is not available. When main host is not available. Sir, here some of the parasites, when their main hosts are not available, they live temporarily in the some other hosts. Why they live on some other host? For the maintenance of their infective nature. So for the maintenance of infective nature, some of the parasites are living in the host. They are called as reservoir host. But reservoir hosts are not affected by the disease. Okay, for the maintenance of infective nature, infective form, the parasite will live in one host when the main host is not available. So that host is called as, the name itself indicating, reservoir host. It hosts for the parasite for the maintenance of its infective stage. Example, monkey. So monkey for Plasmodium. So monkey is a reservoir host. What I said, when the Plasmodium vivax has no availability of man as well as Anopheles mosquito, when the main hosts are not available for Plasmodium, Plasmodium will live temporarily in the monkey. And monkey is not getting disease. So monkey is a reservoir host for the Plasmodium vivax parasite. Okay. Next, African antelope. So African antelope, this is commonly called as gnu. This is for African sleep sickness disease. This is what? African sleep sickness disease. So African sleep sickness disease, that is for. Okay, so reservoir host, example monkey for Plasmodium, and African antelope, gnu for African sleep sickness disease. So when the man is not available for, CC fly is not available for African sleep sickness parasite, that is Trypanosoma gambiense. So Trypanosoma gambiense lives temporarily in the African antelope when the main hosts are not available. So this is about the reservoir host. So three types of hosts are there. Definitive host, in which parasite completes its sexual life cycle. Intermediate host, this is the host in which parasite completes asexual life cycle. Reservoir host, when the main host is not available, some infective stages for the maintenance, they live in one host. So such hosts are called as reservoir host.